Hello, and welcome to TI's Troubleshooting Tips series. It's important to remember when working with TI components and troubleshooting TI components to reference material on ti.com/troubleshooting. In today's training video, we will cover the best practices for sharing oscilloscope images. Providing clear and concise images can expedite the overall troubleshooting process and get you back to production much quicker. Now let's cover some of the best practices when sharing oscilloscope images. Remember, clear and concise oscilloscope images in high resolution can effectively describe the behavior of an electrical anomaly, and they are key to expediting the overall debugging process. These best practices are providing color-coded channels, labeling the channels on the schematic, providing a visual voltage scale and time scale, also zooming into the point of interest along with zooming out of the point of interest. Now that I covered the best practices, I'll give you a few examples of what that looks like on the slides. In this example of an oscilloscope image, we can see a few key details which are important to highlight when sharing with others. First off, the channels are clearly labeled. In addition, we see that the voltage scale is identified for each channel of interest. There's also a clearly labeled time scale in the bottom of the screen, along with providing labels for the waveforms of interest. Now that I've shown you a few best practices for providing oscilloscope images to others using the slide deck, I'll show you a live demonstration using an EVM, a device, and an oscilloscope to monitor the output waveform from the EVM. We'll go ahead and run the oscilloscope to monitor the output signal. Here we can see the output waveform of the device. If you notice, on the upward transition, we see a spike. This is our point of interest. In addition, we are following the oscilloscope best practices for sharing this image with others. So we want to ensure the timestamp, the voltage scale, and the channels are clearly labeled. It's also important to provide high resolution images obtained from the oscilloscope. This is best done by using a USB to save the image. For here, we can use File, Save, and Save the Waveform. Don't forget to zoom into the point of interest as additional information can be obtained. This additional information can help expedite the overall troubleshooting process. Lastly, it's important to provide the zoomed out image to show the overall signal over time. We also want to ensure that the oscilloscope probes are properly calibrated using the calibration tools provided. Now that I've shown you the best practices for providing oscope images to others, let's go ahead and talk about some additional areas we can find technical collateral on TI.com. On this slide, we see a few different websites that we can go to within TI.com. Those are TI's Quality Policies and Processes, TI's E2E Support Forum, and TI Precision Labs. Lastly, TI provides free simulation software for download known as Tina TI. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting tip series on providing best practice oscilloscope images to others. For additional information, please check out ti.com/troubleshooting.